Why can't we find propolis in honeybee hives anymore? Imagine yourself being replaced in a workspace because you enjoy natural herbs. Do you know where the ginger tea is? New company rules, sir. No more ginger tea, no more green tea, or even coffee.
Why?
Because the new boss gets angry with the smell of it.
What do I have to do with that?
Now go back to work. In the last century, a similar situation happened in the beekeeping world. The land-strong hives with movable frames popularized beekeeping around the world, but at the same time, it started a silent behavior among beekeepers with very serious consequences to manage honeybees. Beekeepers are constantly looking for ways to make beekeeping easier. Not a problem with that. The problem starts when the needs of the beekeepers becomes more important than the needs of the honeybees. This is the entrance of a managed honeybee hive. Most beekeepers keep bees in Langstroth hives like this one, and this is the entrance of a honeybee hive in nature, where the bees prefer to live in tree holes like this one, far away from the ground. Do you see the difference? Here's the two side by side for comparison. Please take your time. Try to find out the differences here. Both houses are made of wood, like this one right here. But in nature, for some reason, bees produce something extra, this shiny material that you saw in the video before. This is called propolis, and is a combination of many different resins from many different plant sources that honeybees collect to help to build their nests, and also the natural compounds inside those resins help the bees to fight pests and diseases. This is the ginger tea of honeybees. Actually, this is a terrible comparison because the benefit of ginger tea to humans is not even close to what propolis can do for honeybees. Humans take advantage of the properties of propolis for thousands of years, even though the science is not there yet backing that up. The word propolis comes from the Greek pro, that means in front of or in favor of, and the other word polis, which means city. And apparently it comes from the general idea of the protective properties of propolis to the honeybee hives as a barrier against maladies. A number of studies suggest that propolis have a strong antimicrobial, anti-tumor, and anti-inflammatory properties. And this research field has inspired me to pursue some experiments by myself that I for sure are gonna bring you guys all along this new journey. Today, the use of propolis extract sprays is very common in Japan, in China, in South America, and in Europe, but it's not very common in North America. Mama likes to make her own, and she taught me how to do it by myself, and I still use it today when my throat starts to feel a little funny. If you want to test it out for the first time, Novomel is a brand that I would recommend. No, it's not a sponsored video. Novomel facilities are very close to my farm in Brazil. I know them well. And also they sell on Amazon here in the United States with good reviews. Link in the description. But what about the honeybees? Is propolis any good to honeybees? Dr. Esther Bastos, working at Dr. Marla Spivak's laboratory in Minnesota, was able to show in laboratory conditions that a variety of propolis extracts can inhibit the replication of American foulbrood, a devastating bacterial disease of the honeybees. In another study, Dr. Renata Borba, working in the same laboratory, could show that honeybee colonies with propolis envelope inside the hive perform better against American foulbrood when compared with honeybee hives without propolis envelope. And in the same study, Dr. Borba was able to show that larval food produced in hives with propolis had more antibacterial power compared with food coming from hives without propolis. Basically, the benefit of propolis can be summarized like this. In the individual level, it relaxes the investment of individual bees in immunity. It increases detoxification and antioxidant levels in individual bees and increases the lifespan. And all of that has a significant impact on the colony level. Better immunity and detoxification lead to a reduction of microbial load, decrease of disease,
and increase productivity, population size, and survival.
There are plenty of other scientific articles showing the benefit of propolis to honeybees, and I'm gonna cover many of them in future videos. So if propolis is so good for honeybees, why do we see less and less propolis in honeybee hives in North America? Well, because propolis makes beekeeping harder, and therefore it is not very welcome among beekeepers. It slows them down, it sticks everywhere, makes everything messier. And because of that, along the years, beekeepers start to select genetic stocks of honeybees that produce less and less propolis, intentionally and sometimes unintentionally. Just like the boss shutting down the tea and coffee for his own benefit and not taking in consideration the necessities of the employees, the beekeepers shutting down propolis, they're not thinking about the honeybees, they're thinking about themselves. I remember my first hive assessment when I was around 7 years old back in Brazil, before I come to the United States and become a honeybee researcher at the USDA back in 2006. Dad asked me to go to the apiary and assess one hive. So I was supposed first to go and develop the self-control to work with Africanized bees. And then after that, open a hive and bring some information back home. I was completely embarrassed coming back home with empty hand, with no information at all, because I could not open the hive by myself. I didn't have the strength to open a hive of Africanized bees back in Brazil. And why? Because Africanized bees produce much more propolis than European honeybees in North America. They seal everything together and make things much harder to work with the honeybees. The exactly opposite happened when I arrived in the United States in 2007 to become a honeybee researcher at USDA. Working with my first hive, I wasn't expecting to be that easy to open a hive, and I put so much energy there that the lead almost flew away, and everybody was looking at me and thinking, what the heck is wrong with that guy? After working with the bees that day, I could immediately sympathize and understand why people in the United States and in North America would prefer to work with these bees. They are gentle, they're easy to handle, no much propolis is sticking everything together, no more uncomfortable stings all over my body comparing with the Africanized bees. Yeah, I enjoyed that bee very much. However, I have to say that after 15 years researching honeybees, I'm still advocating for gentle bees, but bees producing less propolis, I changed my mind completely. So to fulfill my curiosity and the curiosity of my followers on YouTube and supporters on Patreon, was to invite Dr. Mike Simone from the Honeybee Research Lab in Baton Rouge, USDA, for a live stream with me in my YouTube channel. So we're gonna be talking about propolis and the benefits of propolis to honeybee health and his latest research on the topic. The live stream is scheduled for August 18 at 7 p.m. Eastern Time, and it's gonna be live on YouTube, Facebook and LinkedIn. It is free to everybody and you can register to the event using the link in the description or going to insidethehive.tv/livestreams. The secret of beekeeping, in my opinion, is balance. The human design to select bees that produce less propolis is a benefit only to the beekeeper and not for the honeybees. Do you think this is good beekeeping? I would love to know your thoughts. If you like this video, please click in the videos at the screen right now to watch more of my content. I'm very happy you're here. Thanks for watching. InsideTheHive.tv, the show about bees. See you guys next week.